Pony Sports. On Vec TV.
Hello everybody and welcome to the Rec Center here in Stillwater. Pony Girls Hockey action against Woodbury tonight, 5 p.m. puck drop. Thanks for joining us on Back TV. I'm Pete Winslow. Along with me is Don Ackerman. And Don, this, again, should be a really great game.
Yeah, really great game. 17-3-1 versus 15-7. Ponies coming off of a loss, as is, and Woodbury's lost 2 out of 3. So both teams are really motivated here. This is the kind of game that gets you ready for sections, and you will need to be able to pass the test that's going to be facing them today.
Yeah, going back to that loss against Roseville Matamidi just a couple days ago, Don, it just feels like the offense for the Ponies just couldn't get rolling like they normally do.
Yeah, defensively, Roseville Matamidi did a great job, and now it'll be interesting to see if Woodbury can kind of do the same. If they've watched that game, they've kind of seen what happened, and, you know, is that a formula to use against Stillwater, or does Stillwater come back? Not usual for them to just score one goal in a game. And so it's interesting to see what happens next.
Also a note that they ran into some penalty trouble, too, in that game. At one point, you know, both Josies and I think Addie Finn were all in the box together, which is not a recipe for success here as the puck is dropped as Woodbury tries to float that one into the zone. So I got to imagine that was also a point of contention for Coach Cashman during this couple days off.
Yeah, she talked to us about that during the second intermission. She might join us again tonight if we're fortunate. And she did mention that those penalties were frustrating to have all happen at the same time.
Here comes Stillwater up the left wing. A couple of different starters here for Stillwater. Earl Beck in, number 20. And also Bell McKenzie.
Yeah.
But that's also a thing Coach Cashman said, that she would be rotating starters just a little bit, especially the defensive pairings.
Yeah, I think she wanted Addie Finn, number 22, working with the second group more, and so we're seeing that for sure tonight, today.
This one goes cross ice, some space here for Woodbury. Takes a shot off the, oh man, that did go under. I thought it went off the post, but that went right under the crossbar. That's number 20, Alexa Bricko, I believe, that scores the goal for Woodbury. Just a couple minutes into this one.
Yeah, really great placement of the shot. You can just see it goes top right corner.
Yeah, high glove.
Just above Lily Timmons' glove, and not much you can do about a shot like that. If you can pick your spot like that, you're going to score.
Well, if anything was going to wake up the Ponies, it might just be that, Don.
Yeah, that's a pretty amazing first start in. Probably has some of the fans wondering, whoa, what's going on?
Well, you go back to that, I mean, the cross-ice entry, she was completely free on that wing.
Yeah, she came down nicely and found her spot.
That's Gronke, I believe, number 14 with the assist on that goal. There's a big pileup in front of Pulaski, and that one finally gets cleared. That'll be an icing.
Do you think 14 with the assist? Okay.
Well, Don, going back to that loss a couple days ago, too, I mean, that was also a thing that we noticed, is just a couple of those long entries for the opposing team. You know, they were getting to the puck first. So I don't know if that's going to be something that Coach Cashman wants to see her defensive wings fly to, you know, a little bit sooner. But can't give up those kinds of transitions getting into your own zone as this one rifles around the backboards.
No, and as far as I, if you're a player, that's kind of what you want to be able to do. You bring the puck in, and if you're someone who can pick her spot, you can find your spot. Odds are you're going to score. You're probably not going to beat Lily Timmons with a straight up, you know, shot. But those top corners, man, they're tough to stop.
That one trapped in the corner, Stillwater trying to get it back up to the top. That was a shot there by number 5, Robinson. A couple players go down. Lang has to play this one back.
She's going to bring the puck up, and her line mates will all change.
She has no problem taking on five defenders. She dumps that one in. Nelson with it in the corner now.
Couldn't find McKenzie, who was cutting toward the net.
Robeck gets in the way of that. Collects it herself.
Nice job defensively by Robeck there to take that puck away and keep it away from Woodbury.
Nelson now spins around, drops it off for St. Martin. Doesn't quite go with her though. Now they get it back up to the top, Earlbeck with it. Takes a shot, don't think that went through.
Hit bodies in front. And that was something that Rosemont Matabita did really well, is blocking shots.
So this one will come back for an icing here. Well folks, if you're just tuning in, you already missed the first goal of the game by number 20, Alexa Bricko for Woodbury.
Assisted by Haley Gronke.
Good cross-ice entry and just shelved it. Lang now with it. Tried to find St. Martin on the left side. She'll pull it back out to Earlbeck. Earlbeck will dump it in. Tried to get it out to Nelson in front. But Woodbury now takes it out. Good stop there by Lang.
Yeah, stopping that entry. That's key.
Kick save there by Pulaski. Off of the Brooke Nelson shot. Lang stretches out to grab that one, dumps it back in. Finn catches it on the side now. Here comes Woodbury trying to break out. A lot of space on that wing again. Timmons has to play this one.
Complete line change. No Royals in the offensive zone.
Finn backhands that one through the middle. Kind of a dangerous saucer pass there, but Chaney picks this one up.
Yeah, luckily Chard was in there to knock it loose.
That one goes down to the Royal zone. Kelsey Rose chases. Addie Finn pinches in on the side.
Taken away from Hoops.
Like you said, Don, in that last game, you know, there was space for the Ponies to work a little bit, but really they were really clogging the lanes, so lots of those shots were not getting clean looks. This here is a good takeaway, and that's another goal.
Number 16.
Abby Lenzik. Puts Woodbury up 2-0. That one kind of just popped out from behind the Stillwater net. And she was just all alone. Let's see the replay here. Another entry into the zone. Yeah, just got her pocket pick there. She took it and
shot away
it
from Chaney, right?
Yeah.
Maybe unassisted based on what we saw there.
So 2-0 now for Woodbury.
Unassisted is what they're saying on the loudspeakers in here.
This one played back to Lang now. Lang bounces it off the sideboards for St. Martin. St. Martin takes a shot. Pulaski holding on to that one. Well, Don, 11 minutes left here in this first period. Not the start you'd want for Coach Cashman's squad.
No, I'm just kind of stunned, honestly, to see that happen. It's Timmons usually is a solid goaltender. I mean, the first shot was certainly impossible to stop. Second one was a nice rebound and, well, a steal and getting out there and just putting it on net. Well done by Woodbury.
That one tried to keep it in on the line, but could not. Now Woodbury will play it back as they try to break out. Find some space coming into the zone. takes a shot. Timmons holds on to that one. That was number five, Brooke Nets. Didn't think she was going to have a lot of room, but she ended up squeezing through on the sidewalls. Made a good power move there, but Timmons on top of that one.
Yeah, but definitely you can see players are getting a chance to go in front of Timmons. Probably want the defense to reduce those opportunities. There's been probably too many so far.
Another one coming right down on Timmons. And even a free puck like that, you had blue sweaters barreling down on her.
Yeah, and in that Woodbury, in the Roseville-Matamita game, we did have a lost puck right in front where a player got a free shot at Timmons. She stopped that one, but you can't do that consistently to your goaltender.
That one came out to number 19, Kaylin Nelson. Desjarnette flips that one out. Robinson in pursuit.
Nice pass through the skates to get it out of the zone. Ooh. Cheney going in. Getting some ice time, literally.
Looks like that was offsides. Face-off controlled by Woodbury. That one gets flipped in. Lang coming to stop the attack. That one gets flipped out. St. Martin takes it, though. She's got a lot of space. Finds Nelson up on the side. Nelson going to drive in. Just loses it, but the arm goes up. Nelson goes down. And that's going to be a penalty against Woodbury.
I think that's the kind of thing that Stillwater needs to do. Be aggressive going toward the net. Picking up a power play, he is really good. If they can start to get some connectivity, some passing going.
Yeah, I mean, and that's about all number, I think, 23 could do. Paige Fashing. That's all you could really do to stop Nelson. She had a good step on her. But again, that was generated from a nice pass from St. Martin on the left wing going cross ice, really stretching the defense. Yeah, St. Martin brings that one in offsides. It's a big opportunity here for Stillwater and the power play unit.
Yeah, penalty's much better than giving up a goal. And if you let Brooke Nelson come down the ice with the puck, you're probably giving up a goal. So smart play.
Yeah,
just prevent the prop. Take the lesser.
Yeah, a penalty you probably got to take. Finn passes it off to Cheney. Little pass back to Finn up the middle. Caught some skates there. That one kept in. Great job there, Lang. Now with it. Passes it back up. Lang goes cross ice to St. Martin. They get it back up. Lang's going to take a shot on that.
Oh,
and that's
just missed.
Yeah. Went right to St. Martin, but that puck was flying up a little bit when it came to her. But that was good movement.
Yeah, good puck movement. And you can see Stillwater trying to find some lanes. I love that. It's a good goaltender you're going to try to beat for Woodbury. So, smart move.
Pulaski goes down. Looks like she snatched that one out of the air.
Yeah, she's got 37 more seconds to stop Stillwater's power play attack.
Don, you said a pretty good goaltender. I mean, Pulaski 10-2-1 with a 1.21 goals against.
Yep.
Pretty good numbers there.
Seven shutouts.
Desjarnette with it. Takes a shot, goes wide. Chard picks it up. She has it in the corner. She'll spin around. They go back up to the top. Gets it right back. Looks like she kind of fanned on that one.
Yeah, Lang went back and got it, though. Everybody's standing up for the high shot there.
Yeah, that one.
You can hear Tim and Stick hitting the ice. That's the end of the power play.
Almost looked like they were going to have an attack there, but the Woodbury player fell down. Stillwater now reclaims it. charred, fighting.
Woodbury has to be super excited about a 2-0 lead and then killing that penalty.
Good glove save there by number 16. Bell McKenzie swatted that one out of the air. Woodbury trying to set up. They have a player in the front, and that one chipped just over the net.
Boy, Ronke couldn't do much better than that.
Timmons kicks that one away. And there's another goal as that one floats out to the middle. Again, I think that was number 14, Ronke.
Yep.
Left pretty much all alone. Had good positioning there.
Boy, and the home crowd is certainly quiet, and but Woodbury is very loud about that third goal. You could see it there. She just sitting in front of the net. They're just setting her up really well. Great team hockey there. Not much that Timmons can do about that.
No, not at all. Lane carrying it up now. St. Martin chasing it up the left side. Sounds like they said Boone with the assist, number 22.
I think that's what I heard too.
Stillwater banking it up the right. They go cross ice with it now. Addie Finn taking it. She'll spin around, trying to look for anybody in the middle. That gets intercepted. Lang takes it now. Takes a shot. Pulaski takes that, though. Stillwater just trying to generate any momentum they can here with just a little bit under 6 minutes left.
She's doing a good job just shutting it down. No rebounds. Stillwater has their work cut out for them tonight, today.
Woodbury wins that faceoff, and they're off and running. Good drop pass there. That one coming up the middle, no one there, but a dangerous pass through the middle. That shot tipped down to a Woodbury player streaking in. That was number 18. Nets didn't get a lot on that, but it was a dangerous play. She was left all alone on that back door, but Timmons was right there.
Yeah, March did a good job there to clear out Mishikoff, who is standing out in front. Lesson learned there. Williams tells Robinson and Chaney to switch sides.
Spin around shot. Whoa, dangerous shot. Timmons kicks that one away. Desjarnet doing a good job to win that up the sideline. A couple players go down. That one rings all the way around, though. Woodbury will change tired legs. March with it now.
Making Desjarnet skate, that's for sure.
Yeah, Don, I think if you're still out of your... I mean, obviously you need your big guns to show up, but really, you know, I think they're going to need more from the bench and the other role players here tonight if they want to mount any sort of comeback.
Yeah, definitely agree with that. I think that was something that would have been a huge lift if any of the, you know, usual cast don't score. Who can come up and help?
That one gets dumped in by March. That'll be icing. Right, because that's the question, Don, with this squad, is who steps up when it's not the core? And we have yet to see that happen here in the last few games. As St. Martin takes this face-off for Stillwater. Lang tries to control it, loses it.
Boy, I tell you, that was a quick, great move.
Yeah, I was going to say, Woodbury.
18.
That shot blocked, another block, and that goes in off of a second and third chance. Woodbury swarming. And Don, you said it here right in the corner. They are so quick to get the puck out in front.
They are, and Coach Timmons, I saw her shrug after that one, and coach said, you want to come out? And I think she said yes.
I mean, again, they did such a great job blocking that off, and then I think that was number 17, Olivia Mishkoff, with the goal. But we'll get confirmation here in a minute. So goalie switch here as Haley Solnitsky comes in. Big hit there.
Yeah, looks like the referees are going to talk about that one a little bit.
St. Martin coming off for Stillwater.
Another look at that.
Yep.
Replay didn't look like she had a lot of negative intent there. I think she was
still a penalty nonetheless.
Still a penalty for sure. Yeah, I can see why they called it.
Absolutely, just some frustration there.
I heard 18.
Yeah, I think she picked up the assist. That was Laney Nets with the assist. That one gets carried in offsides, though.
Well, and I think with the change in goalie, I think it just wasn't Lily's night.
Yeah, and that's going to happen some nights.
And, you know, when Coach asked her, you know, what do you think? She shrugged. I think that's a pretty clear sign that she was maybe not feeling it.
And to be fair, Donna, I don't think all four of those get credited against her.
Oh, no, that last goal was not her fault.
I
think it was redirected on the way to her and just went high over her shoulder.
But, again, you know, those are tough when you're feeling out of rhythm and not in your groove. And so Coach goes with the switch here.
Yeah, and also to be fair, you know, she might be thinking, you know what, the team's struggling, and maybe if we switch the goaltender, that'll fire him up, you know, kind of thing.
Yeah, change it up, try something. As Finn takes this one for Stillwater in the dot.
And I'm an LA Kings fan, and the coach pulled Mike Quick, the goaltender, who's probably going to the Hall of Fame, one game because he told the team, hey, if you're not going to support him, I'm not going to leave him out there.
That's fair too.
And if they're, you know, if Woodbury can camp in front of the net.
Well, here they come.
Then you got to do something.
Woodbury working it up. Nobody in the middle that time.
But they're passing the puck to the right place.
Oh yeah, I mean if you get anybody in that little slot area, that's a high percentage shot. That's what they're going for, and they're not doing it secretly. That's exactly their bread and butter move, obviously, and I mean it's paid off hugely here so far. Another shot in. Solnitsky takes that.
Rebound nice clear. Oh, nice defense there by Solnitsky.
Yeah,
Chaney, I think, forced Brooke Nets to try to go toward the left side of the net.
St. Martin back on the ice now for Stillwater. Not a whole lot of opportunity for Woodbury on that power play.
That's a good thing for...
St. Martin takes the high slap shot. Oh, and that one goes wide. Good potential rebound there for Stillwater. Lang gets it back. Takes a shot. Blocked. Another shot there by St. Martin. Blocked again. Woodbury going to try to work it out now. Lang collects it. Has Brooke Nelson up the sideline. That pass off just a little bit, but she gets it back. Good move there by Nelson. Nelson, and there's a goal. Stillwater on the board now.
Laska. And Nelson did a great job feeding it over to her teammate here. You can see Brooke Nelson gets a chance at it, makes a great move, slides it over. Laska celebrates.
Yeah, fortuitous bounce for Nelson to get that puck back to her, but then she brought it in and did all the heavy lifting, and all Laska had to do was put it home, and she did. Player goes down, Stillwater looking for a penalty, but none coming. Oh, Finn with the save there. That one was going right to a Woodbury player all by themselves out in front. Finn chasing it now.
Yeah, and Woodbury looking good in those blue and white jerseys. And the number of stripes might be the number of goals they have in this game.
So we'll see if that Laska goal injects some new life into Stillwater. By no means is this game overdone. Lots of hockey still. But you really needed something if you're Stillwater right before this first period ends here.
Yeah, the whistle blowing here. Brooke Nelson a little frustrated by being called perhaps offsides. St. Martin heading over to the bench. This has been a very atypical period for Stillwater.
Well, Don, we talked about the obviously, you know, Nelson got the assist there. She did a lot of the heavy lifting, but you wanted some of that that depth to try to find the back of the net. Like I said, Laska, absolutely part of that depth, doing her job when the puck got to her. As the buzzer sounds here, Woodbury up 4-1. Again, Don, sort of atypical. But, I mean, a really fast period for Woodbury. Obviously, they had some really, really stellar chances. And you can see, like you said, they get the puck out of the corner so fast.
Yeah, and they did a great job coming down and finding space and coming down on the attack. And Stillwater just really didn't have an answer for most of what they were doing.
No, and then you can see on that last one, I mean, Nelson doing a great job to set it up herself and then finding Laska for that goal. So if you want to go through the goals, Don,
well,
in
I've
that
got
first period.
Alexa Bricko with the first one, Abby Lenzik with the second one, Haley Grunke with the third one. I didn't catch who had the fourth one. Did you write that down?
We'll check it.
Okay,
in the break.
Good. My mistake, sorry. I got the assist by Lanny Goetz, but it was just, they did a great job coming on the attack and really beating her in different ways. There was a redirect in front. That's why I wasn't sure who chipped that fourth one in. None of those, I don't think much, can't do much as the goaltender when you've got those kind of shots and opportunities. The real key, I think, is get the defense to fight off players and not give them, you know, that space in front of their goaltender.
Yeah, I mean, you can see the defense for Stillwater was just pulled up a little bit too far away from the net, in my opinion. And they, you know, they tried to overcorrect that, I think, and they did a good job not letting some of those pucks go freely to the middle. So we'll see what Coach Cashman wants to do, you know, coming out of the second period. Like I said, lots of hockey left here on Valley X's channel as Woodbury's up 4-1, but we're going to throw it to a quick break and we'll get you all the second period action here when we come back.
Well, it looks like John's trying to make dinner again.
Got the ketchup and mustard?
Yep.
Got the relish?
Yep.
Hot dogs and buns?
Yep. Got the charcoal?
Uh-oh. We're out of charcoal.
What? Well then, what are we gonna eat?
Don't worry, I got you covered.
Hello.
Wow, that was quick.
Yeah, thank you very much.
Thank you, have a good night.
You too.
Hey guys, Papa John's.
Thanks. Oh, yummy.
How'd you know?
I always do. One.
Today
Today we're at the Stillwater Area High School for Da Vinci Fest. The middle and high school students have been working on art and science projects, so let's see what they have.
My project is called Wild Embers, based off a song we sang here in Belgiante. And it basically is a woman's song, a declaration of just all the history that we have as women. Nothing can stop women from progressing and getting the rights that they deserve. And finding that passion and determination is within my art piece. For my digital art, what inspired me was creators like The Odd Ones Out, Jane Animation, Alex Hirsch, essentially just digital animators. I can draw water. I've never drawn water before because I've always shied away from it because it's such a delicate element. And drawing that took 3.5 hours with the sketch and all, and I'm just really excited that I got to show the depth and the tranquility and the different elements of water and the shine and everything. It's super cool.
It's a painting of outer space, what I think it would look like to me. My sister spilled her paint on her painting that she was making, and then she was going to throw it away, and I thought that was a waste of paint. So I took the painting and turned it into something different myself.
I used alcohol markers to create it. The idea behind it, I really wanted to make the person standing here feel really small and cold. A lot of lighting and photography. I really like the way shadows are cast in certain pictures I've seen, and I kind of wanted to recreate that within the piece. I learned a lot about perspective and placing people within perspective.
So my painting here is with oil painting, and I try to describe what it feels like to have negative emotions. I will say doing this piece in the past, this was my first time with oil painting, and before this I was doing 5 different pieces and I did not like them, and this was just me having straight anger at a piece. So the smudges on the side describe people's emotions, and also describes my emotions in this piece. My inspiration was really my face in my mirror, and all the colors you're seeing is actually what my colors were portraying in my mirror. I'm a person who likes it to look centered, and this kind of got me out of my comfort zone because it's not totally how I wanted it. I actually tried to discard it at first, but I just kept it because it's imperfect, and I actually like this with this piece.
So this painting, I wanted it to signify two different figures, creating unity, coming together as one. And I wanted it to be my piece is called Mystic Lovers, and I wanted it to combine the difficulties in the world and the troubles in the world. But once you found your one person, everything is blocked out. The inspiration was actually based on me and my relationship and what I've gone through, and I thought that this piece described it very well on how I used my materials. I discovered that charcoal smears pretty easily, and I discovered that abstract art is one of my favorite things now once I did an abstract piece.
So this is called the Cube of Fate. Each side has a different meaning correlating to something that you might get on that roll. So reverse, chaos, time, normal, light, and insight. My dad is very in touch into H.P. Lovecraft and sort of that horror genre of, oh, that's very cool and that's very his second, but I also want to incorporate my aesthetic. So that colorfulness but still kind of creepy vibe if you look at it a certain way. I was watching a video and they were talking about crayons just for little kids, and I'm like, no, it's not. I used crayon and it was one of my favorite sides. You can use whatever medium you want. No one can stop you.
Thank you. an organization that promotes sustainability in the community. What that means in sustainability is we focus specifically on preservation, improvement of natural resources, creating healthy lifestyles in the community, and then also creating economic vitality. So within that is we work with businesses on a thing called Green Business Directory to promote waste reduction and energy.
Hello, everybody, and welcome back to the Rec Center here. Getting ready for second period action. I'm Pete Winslow. Along with me is Don Ackerman here on Valley Access Channels. Thanks for joining us. And if you're tuning into the stream, you've seen some really cool highlights from last year's Da Vinci Fest, where students get to show off their artistic creations. And that's actually happening this weekend. So if you're in the area, please come on by and check that out. Some really great stuff. As the puck is down now, St. Martin carries that one in. That one gets intercepted. But taken right back, Nelson trying to go backdoor to Lask on the other side. Woodbury taking it in now.
And that tandem has the Stillwater goal that they scored with 1 minute left in the first period.
St. Martin trying to drive, but she loses it. Lang with it, tries to find Laska.
Laska tripped up literally, and the referee saw it.
Yeah, Laska now on this line. I don't remember if she started with this line, but clearly coach liked what she was seeing, giving her some more ice time. Well deserved.
16-24. So just a fresh new period, and Stillwater gets exactly what they need. A power play, number 18 in the box.
Yeah, that's Lainey Netz in the box for tripping. Addie Finn takes the faceoff. Stillwater tries to collect it. Lang had it for a moment. It gets stripped away, and here's Woodbury off to the races. That one rings wide. Nelson plays it back. Stillwater still has not controlled it yet. Finally, Cheney has it. Looking to start a breakout play. And here comes Stillwater. St. Martin up the sideline. She'll just take it herself. She's got some space. Takes a shot. She gets pulled down.
She sledded by the net after she took that shot.
Lang spins it back to Finn. Finn gets it across to St. Martin. Good move there by St. Martin as she brought it in. Really, she was looking for some help, but then she realized how much space they were giving her.
Right.
And said, I'll just take it. Lang goes cross-ice. Nelson takes a shot, and that's a goal! Power play goal. Brooke Nelson pulling the ponies within two, just what the doctor ordered if you're Stillwater, right, Don?
Absolutely perfect. I mean, great energy coming out of the break. They come out. Here you can see Lang has one pass directed, finds a second shot, goes across the ice. Nelson just slides in.
You saw the patience by Nelson, too. She could have taken the shot right away from Lang's pass, but she ended up holding onto it, really picking out her spot, and absolutely rewarded as she should be here at Stillwater, down 4-2 now in a big power play opportunity. Another player goes down for Stillwater. I think that was Williams that went down. Finn fighting on the sideboards with it. That one's gonna come all the way down, so we'll go all the way back.
And I think both Josies got the assists on that one. St. Martin with the second assist.
That was a great job, too, by Josie St. Martin to keep that one in at the blue line, too, because it was a bouncing puck, and she was able to just get it over to Lang that set her up for that pass.
Right.
Another shot coming in, kicked, saved by Pulaski.
That did not get through to Robinson, but the idea was get one of their players in front of the net. Finn comes over and loses her stick, but trades it for a hit.
Yeah, still no stick, though. This one taken by Stillwater. Woodbury recollects, tries to enter the zone.
Boy, you know, bad news if you can't clear your zone. Number 23 chips it forward. Paige Fasching to Zolnitsky, who subbed in for Timmins after that fourth goal by Woodbury. So while she's been on the ice, a 2-0 difference for Stillwater.
That one's tied up in the corner.
And so far, this is the kind of comeback I think you want to see after going down 0-4, unbelievably.
That one gets thrown into the zone. Woodbury swarming. March tries to flip it out. That one goes right into the St. Martin, but that one comes back, and that'll be an icing.
Yeah, you saw lots of players' arms going up to indicate that was going to be called. It's one of the first ones Woodbury has iced.
That one rings around the boards. Woodbury collecting it, trying to get it up to the top, and they do. And Solnitsky is right there. Dangerous shot. Once again, though, they found her right in that dangerous area. That was Natalie Meter in the slot. Stillwater gonna try to break out now. They have a little bit of space. Here comes March. Passes it back. Chard. Chard loses it. Here comes Woodbury up the side. Good stick there by Finn, though.
Boy, and Woodbury's done a good job of recovering after Stillwater came after him pretty fast and hard at the beginning of this period.
Chard loses it. That shot comes in, fired in by number 20, Bricko. They work it back up to the blue line. Another save there for Solnitsky. Finn chases it. She'll throw it up the ice. Finally, Stillwater can change. Feels like hasn't been over here for a while. Good defense there by Stillwater to strip that one away. And here comes Nelson. Tried to go cross ice for Laska. It's cut off, though.
Yeah, good idea. Might have been too soon because the Woodbury players were defending that really well.
Lang doing a good job. Could have went in, but decided not to, as that one's going to get iced.
Another icing by Woodbury. All those icings might be buying them time, but I think they're buying what Stillwater wants is time in the offensive zone. If they can win a faceoff and score, we saw them do it pretty quickly in one of the previous games you and I were at. In fact, Coach felt confident on that she called a timeout with 9 seconds left in a period because she thinks she can win the faceoff and get a shot on net.
Well, Don, I mean, we've watched hockey for years, and you can always kind of tell when a team's continuously icing it. It can mean few things. That one takes a shot, goes wide though.
I was almost wondering if that was an assist attempt.
Right, good. Trying to set up that player on the right side.
Good defense by Stillwater, but Woodbury back in the zone. Now back out.
Stillwater collects that one. Gets flipped out.
Nice job bringing it in, but Woodbury takes it away.
Lang having to play defense now. Goes for the poke, misses it. Gets it back, though, but that's going to be a whistle. I think that's going to be on number 6, Grace Chaney.
Yeah, it looks like Chaney's going into the box. So after a good fight back here to get it to 2-4,
like she just hooked her there. That was number 14, Haley Gronke, with a really slick move to make her way in front of the goal. Oh, Nelson had it for just a second. Oh, that one not cleared. Here come Woodbury with numbers potentially. Drop pass, takes a shot, and that one goes in. That's number 20. Bricko again, I believe. Brooke Netz did a great job to enter the zone and dropped it right back for her teammate.
Now both teams have scored on the power play. Boy, when you look at this play, you can see that Finn stands up real tall to try to make herself as small as possible, but Bricko puts it on the right side of the net. Really great play. She actually took advantage, I think, of Addie Finn being in front.
So another penalty coming against Woodbury. Wow, a lot of crazy action here in the last couple seconds. Woodbury up 5-2 now. Yep. But going down a player here.
You can see Tate Martin taken down here. They called that penalty on number 22, Madison Boone. Madison has an assist in this game.
Lang with a shot and the goal right on cue. Josie finds Josie. And just like that, Ponies 3, Royals 5.
That's second power play goal as we see get a replay look at hit. Lang turned, St. Martin turns it in and gets it to Josie, who just fires it into the net.
She's not missing on that one over here in this left dot or this left circle. What a way to respond, but here comes Woodbury again. She loses it though.
Boy, really great idea there by Netz, Lanny Netz, to try to stretch it out and see if she can find an opening behind number one for Stillwater.
This is going to be icing against Stillwater. Well, Don, 10 minutes left here in the second period. I'm out of breath already. I mean, it seems like just the action has been nonstop so far.
I mean, really game on as far as how this is going. And timely-wise, exactly what Stillwater needed. After going down 5-2 to get back, to climb back in.
Well, think about it, too. I mean, we were at 4-0 for a
right.
while. And that, I'm sure, doesn't feel... that's just a very distant memory at this point. A very different feeling game now that it's 5-3.
Grace Cheney with the second assist on that goal by Josie Lang from Josie St. Martin.
Finn trying to out-muscle her player. Stillwater looking to break out. St. Martin has it. Finds Nelson. Nelson takes a shot. Oh, good blocker save there by Pulaski. This one kept in. Another shot. Pulaski has to jump on it. Not clean. Still maybe not clean. And it comes out.
Yeah, puck goes loose.
Oh, and there, here comes number 17. She's got a ton of space. We'll see if she can catch up. That's Mishikoff. She obviously had no help. Some players were changing. No harm, though, for Stillwater. St. Martin goes down again. No call. Finn shovels that one out. Goes right to St. Martin again. She'll bail for some reinforcements. Finn just takes a shot right into the defender.
Yeah. Bella Mishkoff paid for that one.
Yeah, you could tell she was a little bit stung on that one. She gingerly goes over the boards for a change. Got her right in the midsection. Woodbury now cycling it around. Trying to work it back to the top. Stillwater reclaims it. They make their way up. It's Desjarnet. Spins around, loses it though.
Had the pocket picked. Now Riley Robinson comes from behind and returns the favor.
Solnitsky will jump on that one. You know, Don, all in all, Solnitsky, I feel like, has done a pretty good job coming in for relief of Timmins. It's obviously a near impossible job to come in, you know, when you're that early in a game. but she's absolutely done a great job so far for Stillwater. As much as you could ask for in a goalie relief kind of situation.
Yeah, shots on net are now coming, are starting to move up. It was 6-12 at the end of one. Now it's 12-17, so we're seeing it even out as Stillwater gets on the board and has some a boost of energy after a pretty rough first period.
Rose now fighting for it, looking for some help. Chard. Chard loses it. Right in the zone, though. That one gets cleared out by Nets. Oh, big check there, and that's going to be a penalty. That's number 5, Brooke Nets. Putting Rose to the ice.
Here's a look at that. Oh, yeah, a high check, too.
Yeah, came up high.
Putting the stick around their neck. That power play, 7:44. Stillwater 2-for-3 on the power play. Addie Finn got tripped up there.
St. Martin laying with it now all alone. Could take all the time she wants. Takes a shot. Finn was right there being an agitator, but Pulaski holds on to that one. Looked like she bobbled it just for a minute, but still was able to control it.
Yeah, if you bobble the puck in front of somebody, they're going to come in after it. That's pretty normal.
Get on that replay. Lang hit all the time in the world. Could just pick her shot. Pretty good setup here. Lang, Josie's working for it. That gets up to the top. Chaney with it. Lang goes across ice.
Oh, nice pass.
Yeah.
Surprised it got through.
Lang with it again. Takes a shot. Oh, good save there by Pulaski. They're giving Lang a lot of space over here, which has been surprising. Nelson up the middle, back to, oh my goodness, Lang, I can't even keep up.
There it is.
And Lang pokes it in. Woodbury players up in arms, but Stillwater, Don, I can't even call the action as I see it.
That's the second time that Lang's put it in, and that was a, you just saw like a lot of fighting going on in front of the net. Here you can see Nelson brings it over.
I don't even know if Lang maybe got the last touch on that. It
I don't think she. I think you're right.
Stick, based on the replay, but regardless, here it's 5-4.
We're trying to listen to the stadium announcer.
Well, we'll double check.
Sounded like they might have said Addie Finn.
Yeah, that's what I heard too. We'll check the Ponies' Twitter X account to see.
I mean, she might have been chopping in the middle there. Now get a good look at Dejarnet, number 29.
Well done.
But 4-5 is a huge change in momentum as far as this game goes. It was 4-0, as you indicated, or 0-4 if you're tracking it from Stillwater first.
I was just about to say, 6:39 left in this period, Don. Game on. As this one comes all the way down.
Boy, and Stillwater had trouble getting started, but now that they're in this game, they are flying around, and that last goal showed the amount of effort that you got to put in. We didn't see anything like that in the first period.
No, not at all. And if, honestly, you know, if you're Woodbury Scott Waldo, the head coach, you got to not want to take penalties like that, like that Nets just took. A needless one, to say the least.
Right.
And that's really, like you said, you know, Stillwater's really been cashed in on the power play so far.
3 out of 4.
Yeah, that's the reason they're in this game.
And we've seen them on the power play in the last couple games where the power play really wasn't providing a great change in momentum, or, you know, where you feel like the ice is slanted.
Well, they couldn't get those cross-ice passes that they're doing tonight.
Right.
And, it's baffling to me, at least, when they're giving Lang here that much space.
Boy, I tell you, if Nelson could have got that through, Nelson got hit on the arm.
Yeah.
She's coming off.
It. It does not look good.
Get her a massage therapist. That magic spray that the soccer players have. Get
That's
some
right.
of that on her arm.
St. Martin carries it in now. Has some space. March with it now. Take a shot in. Pulaski with the save.
Trying to get that to Desjarnette or March, who is in front.
Here comes Woodbury up the side. Zielinski
that
holds onto that one.
Right into the chest of Zielinski, so safe bet there. And you see the players coming over congratulating. That's good. I mean, there's been a big turn of events since Lily Timmons was pulled out of the game, and it was 0-4 at the time when that happened.
But yeah, I just want to finish the point there. I mean, they're giving Lang just tons of space here on that power play, on that left circle where she loves to just sit and wait. We'll see if Stillwater gets another opportunity, if Woodbury changes how they defend that next time. Woodbury comes away with this. Players fighting for it now behind the net. Big scrum. Couple players go down.
Yeah, and interestingly enough, we have number 14 was kind of crawling on her knees. Gronke, Haley Gronke was crawling down the ice, and that doesn't seem like a great idea.
Nets down with it for Woodbury. Turns around, flips it off the boards. Finds her teammate, Meter.
So according to the mngirlshockeyhub.com, we have Addie Finn with the goal, assisted by Josie Lang and Josie St. Martin. So in that scrum where the puck was loose, Addie Finn was the last one to touch it for Stillwater. Certainly if Lang could have got there, she would have definitely powered that into the net with the sprawling Woodbury goaltender.
Don, good to see Brooke Nelson back on the ice.
Yeah, that's good. She must have got that stinger dealt with.
Because, yeah, when she went off the ice, she was in some pain, let's say. That face-off comes away for Woodbury. Gets taken, though, by Stillwater. They ring it up the boards. Laska tries to flip it out for St. Martin. A couple players go down again in a heap. Finn chasing it. That'll be icing. So we'll come down to the Woodbury defensive zone.
And the Woodbury icings, I think, are starting to give Stillwater an advantage, I think, in this game, and they've got to be a little annoyed that it's 4-5.
Woodbury wins that faceoff, though. Goes right to Lang. Lang carries it, takes a shot in, blocked. Second chance, third chance, fourth chance. Pulaski finally grabs it.
Chip low. Everybody's putting their stick in there. St. Martin's coming into the fray. She was in the middle of it. I think she might have been pushed in the back. She's certainly yelling some stuff at the Woodbury team.
They're going to move it outside the zone.
St. Martin, not expecting that, was lining up. You can see the scrum in front. And, yep, she did get pushed in the back. So the Woodbury players actually pushed one of the Stillwater Ponies onto their goalie.
Nelson fires that in. Stillwater trying to keep it in. They do. Nelson battling in the corner for it. Laska fighting.
St. Martin got it. Oh, she tried to chip it out to Lang.
Here comes number 14, Grunky. Oh, good defensive move there, though. Nelson with it. Loses it for a second. Players get tangled up. Robinson trying to get it to Nelson.
Yeah, stick came up to Nelson's face. She's got the cage on her face, so she's protected.
That one's still going to stay in. Robinson throws it in again, doesn't get through. Stillwater doing a pretty good job of keeping the puck in the zone, too.
And staying on the attack. Every time they win one of those, that's a lot of times that's the big difference between a goal and a no goal, is having your teammates keep the puck in the zone, keeping on the attack, and not have giving the defense the time to reset.
That one got carried in offsides. We'll get a face-off here. just under 3 minutes. Stillwater playing it back around their own zone, trying to get it out. Ooh, that one dangerously in the middle. It gets chipped out, though. Does it exit the zone? It finally does. Comes right out to Finn. Finn, throw it in.
Throws it in and gives number five a shoulder. Brooke Nets.
Looks like that one was offsides again. Not sure who was offsides, though. Regardless, we get a face-off here. Rose takes the face-off for Stillwater. Woodbury comes away with it, though. That one gets dumped in.
Natalie Meter dumping that into the attack zone. Stillwater doing a good job getting down the ice.
Chard was stuck on the offsides end. She got knocked down.
Sure looks like a different team in the second period, that's for sure.
Yeah, I mean, what a testament to this team to really grind it out and come back to make this a real game here. Like I said, Don, I mean, really, remember, this game was 4-0 at one point.
Right.
And I would not have been able to predict what
5-4?
We've seen. Yeah, what we've seen so far.
No, it's great. Like you said, it's a great testament. But Woodbury's not done. They're still fighting.
Big save there by Solnitsky. That was number 14, Gronke with a shot. Gronke's had some really good looks tonight. Now St. Martin here takes a shot. Oh, off the post! Gets taken down for her effort.
Wow. Shots on goal are now 18 to 20. So we've said that tells the story of this period.
1 minute left here. Laska almost hits the ref.
Couldn't get out of the way.
Stillwater trying to keep that in. Just misses the player on the far side. That'll be icing coming all the way back down.
Another icing. 43 seconds left in this period. Good time for Stillwater to get an opportunity in the offensive zone. A lot of time if you can win this faceoff, just St. Martin in there ready to go.
Just about 43 seconds left here in the second period. Stillwater.
Madison Boone.
Down 5-4.
Oh, nice job clearing.
Stillwater takes it back. Finn carries it in. Gets bumped off the puck. Nelson with it. Plays it up the board. Gets pulled down, though. Woodbury comes away with it. Comes right back to Nelson. She's got to get up and grab it. Stillwater still has it. Nelson back to Finn. Oh, tried to go cross ice. It was there. Just not enough power on it.
Yelling.
Finn with it.
You hear the players yelling because they were watching the clock.
And a couple good chances there at the end as the horn sounds. But with that done, second period ends. Woodbury up 5-4, but what a period for Stillwater as they pull themselves back into this game. But with that, we're going to go to a break, and we'll come back to debrief at some point here, right here on Valley Access Channels.
Well, it looks like John's trying to make dinner again.
Got the ketchup and mustard?
Yep.
Got the relish?
Yep.
Hot dogs and buns?
Yep. Got the charcoal?
Uh-oh. We're out of charcoal.
What? Well then, what are we gonna eat?
Don't worry, I got you covered.
Hello.
Wow, that was quick.
Yeah, thank you very much.
Thank you, have a good night.
You too.
Hey guys, Papa John's.
Nice.
Oh, yummy.
How'd you know?
I always do. One.
Stillwater Area High School for Da Vinci Fest. The middle and high school students have been working on art and science projects, so let's see what they have.
My project is called Wild Embers, based off a song we sang here in Belgiante. And it basically is a woman's song, a declaration of just all the history that we have as women. Nothing can stop women from progressing and getting the rights that they deserve, and finding that passion and determination is within my art piece. For my digital art, what inspired me was creators like The Odd Ones Out, Jane Animation, Alex Hirsch, essentially just digital animators.
Okay.
I can draw water. I've never drawn water before because I've always shied away from it because it's such a delicate element. And drawing that took 3.5 hours with the sketch and all, and I'm just really excited that I got to show the depth and the tranquility and the different elements of water and the shine and everything. It's super cool.
It's a painting of outer space, what I think it would look like to me. My sister spilled her paint on her painting that she was making, and then she was going to throw it away, and I thought that was a waste of paint. So I took the painting and turned it into something different myself.
I used alcohol markers to create it.
Hello, everybody, and welcome back to the Rec Center. I'm Pete Wins. Along with me is Coach Annie Cashman of the Stillwater Ponies girls hockey team. Coach, what a crazy game so far. I mean, I would never have guessed from being down 4-0. We're at 5-4 right now. What are your thoughts so far?
Well, I'm really proud of the girls. I mean, these kids care a lot, and they have a lot of pride. And, you know, they just had a bad 10 minutes of hockey, and that happens. And credit to Woodbury. They buried every chance they got. But, you know, it's a sign of a team that bounces back, and there's no quit, no panic in the girls. You know, our power play seems to be clicking tonight, so that's good to see. And I like our chances going into the third. You know, we've also hit a couple pipes, and I think we should be winning right now. So, I mean, all in all, I don't like spotting a team 4 goals, but I love our effort, and I love our no quit, and I'm excited for the third period.
Yeah, I feel like in the power play in the last couple of games, it's been a little tough to start the shape and get everybody moving and stuff and the lanes opening up. But tonight it's been really clicking. What can you attest to that or attribute to that?
Well, I have Josie St. Martin and Addie Finn and Brooke Nelson and Josie Lang on the team. And Grace Cheney is a very calming influence. I mean, they're world-class hockey players. And so I knew it would take us a while with Josie getting back from her trip and just getting over jet lag and feeling better. And we made one switch between Brooke and Addie, and we worked on it for about 45 minutes yesterday at practice, and it looked great. So I knew if we could get to the power play, we'd have some luck tonight. And they're just world-class hockey players. They're very, very offensively gifted hockey players. And so if Woodbury wants to keep hooking and tripping and dogging us, then they're going to pay for it, and we're going to make them pay. And so I think that we played better in the third, in the second, but we still are giving up too many things behind us, and we're not getting the puck deep enough. So if we can do that, I think we're going to get rolling here in the third.
I feel like a standout for that second period was Bryn Laska, obviously getting on the score sheet tonight. What have you liked out of her and her minutes, obviously rewarding her with a little bit more time at the top unit?
I love Bryn Laska and Audrey Hackler. They're exactly what our team has needed, and Emma Chard, and I have talked a lot about them all year, but those guys have energy, and they have a lot of passion for hockey, and they're just very positive people to be around. And Brinny is, you know, I've said this, I think, before, kind of our new Avery Brownhausen. Avery was our energy bunny last year, and kind of when things were deep and we needed someone to pull, you know, Avery does that, and Brinny does that. And I mean, at the end of the first period, that couldn't have been bigger. We needed to get one on the board. And credit to Brooke for trusting Bryn make that pass across and Bryn buries it. We know what a play, but you know, we've been preparing Bryn to do this all year long, and then that's her job. She's got to go do it, and she's getting an opportunity tonight because she has energy and she can forecheck. So I love those guys. I'm so proud to be their coach, and I'm lucky they're mine.
What can you say about Haley Solnitsky coming in too tonight? I mean, obviously a tough situation no matter what goalie, you know, has to come in relief.
I mean, it's heartbreaking that this is Lily Tibbins' last home game and we didn't show up the first, you know, we just got in a little bit of a funk the first few minutes of the game, and that happens. And, you know, I give Lily a lot of credit. She agreed with me that we need to change the vibe and throw Haley in. Haley's one of the best freshman goalies in the country, so we have a lot of confidence in her. The future is very bright for her. I give her a lot of credit for stepping into the game. I'm heartbroken that Lily's not in there right now, and you know, we'll see how the rest of the night goes. But Haley's a great goalie, and she's worked really hard this year to put herself in this position.
And if you can just sum it up simply, what's it going to take to get back in this game? Obviously, it's right there for the taking still. A lot of hockey left.
We got a forecheck. We gotta be on the you know, the red line in the offensive zone. We gotta go play down in the lobby, you know, with all the fans. We can't sit down here and hope it's gonna work out. So I think we'll do it. I think we'll get forechecking and get after it and put a really good effort here in the third period. We have our energy is completely different tonight than it was on Tuesday.
All right, thanks, Coach. Good luck the rest of the way.
Well, it looks like John's trying to make dinner again.
Got the ketchup and mustard?
Sounds good.
Yep.
Got the relish?
Yep.
Hot dogs and buns?
Yep. Got the charcoal?
Uh-oh. We're out of charcoal.
What? Well then, what are we gonna eat?
Don't worry, I got you covered.
Hello.
Wow, that was quick.
Yeah, thank you very much.
Thank you, have a good night.
You too.
Hey guys, Papa John's.
Thanks. Oh, yummy.
How'd you know?
I always do. One.
Stillwater Area High School for Da Vinci Fest. The middle and high school students have been working on art and science projects, so let's see what they have.
My project is called Wild Embers, based off a song we sang here in Belgiante. And it basically is a woman's song, a declaration of just all the history that we have as women. Nothing can stop women from progressing and getting the rights that they deserve, and finding that passion and determination is within my art piece. For my digital art, what inspired me was creators like The Odd Ones Out, Jane Animation, Alex Hirsch, essentially just digital animators. I can draw water. I've never drawn water before because I've always shied away from it.
Oh,
like John's trying to make dinner again.
Got the ketchup and mustard?
Yep.
Got the relish?
Yep.
Hot dogs and buns?
Yep. Got the charcoal?
Uh-oh. We're out of charcoal.
What? What are we gonna eat?
Don't worry, I got you.
Hello.
Wow, that was quick.
Yep, thank you very much.
Thank you, have a good night.
You too.
Hey guys, Papa John's.
Hey. Oh, yummy.
How'd you know?
I always.
Preserve those local events that last a lifetime. Visit the VAC TV store on your computer or mobile device to purchase school programs and community events. DVD, Blu-ray, and digital downloads are available. Make it easy and search for your program that you wish to purchase. Buying is convenient with multiple options at your disposal while checking out. Visit VACTV.org/store today.
Getting dumped by text is harsh. Try getting dumped by tennis ball. My ex owner drove me out to the woods, yelled fetch, and by the time I bought the ball back, he was gone. But the folks at the shelter helped me let go of my anger. I learned coping skills, like taking it to the hole. Boom! Now I'm ready to fetch again.
Me and my boy Matt had it good. He had catnip that was off the hook. But one day, he brings a girl home, and she's allergic to cats.
Welcome back to the Rec Center for third period action. And Don, action, there will be action. I know there will be. As Woodbury finds themselves up 5-4. And once again, this was a 4-0 game in favor of Woodbury, but now Stillwater has done a great job of climbing back. Obviously, the job's not done yet. But like I said, there will be fireworks here in this third period. And if you want to show the folks who scored, because there was a lot to go through and sift through in that second period.
Yeah, it all started real quick with Lanny Netz getting the tripping call. The Ponies turned that into a power play, scoring by Brooke Nelson, assisted by Josie Lang and Josie St. Martin. And then we had another penalty. Alexa Bricko got an unassisted goal. Another power play. Josie Lang scores, assisted by St. Martin and Grace Cheney, number six. And then another penalty, and Addie Finn scores with a kind of in a scrum situation, assisted by Josie Lang and Josie St. Martin. Basically, those were the players on the ice as all of that drama was unfolding. I think the last player to hit it was one of the Woodbury Royals before it went in the net.
Yeah, lots of action, like I said. And, you know, you heard Coach Cashman say in the interview, I mean, if Woodbury wants to keep going into the box, they're going to make them pay. And, I mean, 3-for-4 on the power play as Netz takes this one, whistles it wide, though. But, yeah, I mean, 3-for-4 on the power play, they've been looking really good getting those cross-ice passes between the Josies and Brooke Nelson in the middle. I mean, everything was absolutely working for them when they're up a player.
Yeah, and it's something that we haven't seen connecting in a while in the games that we've seen. So it's good to see the power play, you know, be used to full advantage. Woodbury 1-for-2 on the power play on their side, so 50%.
Finn dumps that one into the Woodbury zone. They'll collect it, try to work out. But that's Rose giving chase, doing a good job of clamping down on the player. Finn throws it in, and that's a goal. We're going to have to look at the replay. I couldn't tell how that went in. Finn celebrating for her teammate. And there's the team celebration, bowling pins, 5-5. And this all started with Kelsey Rose clamping down.
And I'm reading this right, it's McKenzie with the goal, assisted by Finn.
Ladies and gentlemen, 5-5. And we'll listen to see who got the goal and the assists, but.
And we'll have a whistle here.
Like I said, Finn shot it, but she certainly did not celebrate like she scored it.
No, she was celebrating for her teammate.
Mackenzie, from what we think. I'd also like to point out, well, we'll hear who scored here.
Belle Mackenzie.
Yes, sir. Belle Mackenzie with that one, thanks to a helper from Finn. And I know she didn't get an assist on this, but I have to throw out Kelsey Rose's name. She did such a great job getting in on the Woodbury defender to make sure that the puck never left the zone.
I mean, that's the key. If you can keep the puck in the zone, a lot of those turned into goals because the defense can't reset. It's huge.
St. Martin takes a shot. Pulaski knocks that one away. It comes out for Woodbury.
Well, we got
almost had a break there.
So we have a nice 14 and a half minutes of hockey left, and this game is tied.
Woodbury now trying to go through the middle. Solnitsky plays that one away. Lang with it. Ooh, kind of a careless throw out there by Lang. Not something you see. St. Martin plays it around the boards, though. Lang with it. She's going to flip that out of danger.
Yeah, we've seen 10 goals in this game, and you might think, oh, that must be some pretty sloppy defense or goaltending. No, it's been solid goaltending, and the shots have just been spectacular.
That's what's exciting. I mean,
it's not the goalie's fault this is a 5-5 game.
No, absolutely not.
I mean, there's been some defensive opportunities and offensive opportunities.
Well, and a lot of it is, you know, sometimes the defenses break down, and what happens when good offenses, they capitalize on those mistakes, and that's exactly what we've been seeing so far. Really has nothing to do with who's in between the pipes.
No, I don't think there's anybody else in the state that would have probably stopped any of the pucks that we've seen go in the net.
That one's going to be offsides.
Boy, did it. Real yeoman's job there by Lanny Netz, trying to see if she could keep that puck on the offensive zone. Because, like you said, keeping the offensive zone means you stay leaning on the attack, and it can lead to a goal.
And it seems like Nets had the puck for forever there, just spinning around, taking on all the Stillwater defenders.
Yeah, but not being able to go forward, right? They're
right.
Doing a good job stopping her. And if you got to back up, that's smart. Do it. You know, we've seen St. Martin do that a lot. She finds space where there's openings. Great idea.
Finn flips that one on net. Saves it from going out.
There, stays in net, and then look at that. Now you have a face-off right in front because of what Finn had done.
And I got to think with plays like that, it's like, yes, you know, it's not a high percentage shot, but if you get a face-off in the offensive zone, that's advantage Stillwater in their opinion, right?
Yep, yeah.
That's a good strategy.
Well, it is, especially when you've got Belle Mackenzie, who just scored the last goal, sliding in on net, and if there's a rebound, she's there for it.
Nelson with a great shot, goes wide. Marge plays it out. Laska fighting for it. Comes out to Finn. Finn once again splitting time between both units. Laska now with it. Let's highlight Laska for a minute. She's obviously playing with the top line right now tonight, putting in real solid minutes, as well as netting it. Maybe the most important goal tonight.
Yeah, and she's putting in the work. She's a senior. She's been, ooh.
Wow, that one came right out. After some shoving there, that's number 14. Gronke came straight out. Solnitsky had to make an absolutely massive save right in her face, 1v1.
Yeah, and Gronke got some attention of Josie St. Martin. Looked like we have a pretty feisty matchup here. You can see St. Martin says, enough chipping at my goalie. Now, Woodbury wasn't very happy when Finn was doing the same thing, so.
I don't think that's going to stop.
No.
Pulaski plays that away. Had some players barreling in on her, though. Going cross-ice, Lang has to chase it.
Some really nice cross-ice passes here that are just, if you can get someone to find them.
Lang on the back foot now. Oh, good move. But good job by the Stillwater defense collapsing. Desjarnet takes that one.
Yeah, Cheney on defense doing a great job.
Desjarnet rifles that. That's going to go out of play.
And the coaches keep cycling who's starting on defense, and I think you can see why, is because each player will come up and step up. Earl Beck, Cheney,
Chard.
March, Chard, all of them come in, and they're certainly not duplicates of one another, but just more waves and waves and waves of defense. Stillwater wants that defensive presence to be shown.
No, I mean, this has been a true team effort, I'd say, so far. Obviously, the top core doing their job, putting the points on the board. Solnitsky holds on to that one. But
good
but really
job there.
Getting,
no rebound.
Really getting good depth play here from the bench.
Yeah, and you can see Abby Lindeck just really coming in fast. She has a goal tonight and today, and she's looking to get a second one. Keep an eye on her crashing toward the net. So no rebounds is key, I think, for Solnitsky.
Well, Don, it's about 6:30. I'd say it's a pretty good time to call Papa John's a Stillwater for dinner.
Oh, great
time.
Idea. Yes. Yep, puck's coming around. Pete made sure it didn't hit him.
Unlike last time.
Yes. No, you're right. It's a little chillier down here on the ice where we're sitting, and a warm pizza sounds really nice right now.
That's right. Go out to Papa John's a Stillwater. Give them a call. Give them an order. Get a hot pizza delivered to you. Tonight?
Yeah, that would be good.
As Stillwater tries to finish this game off 5-5 with 11 and a half left here.
And maybe order another one this weekend when you go to Da Vinci Fest, which is happening at the high school.
That's right. I'm Pete Winslow. Along with me is Don Ackerman here on Valley Access Channels. Thank you for joining us tonight for just an absolutely crazy game so far. Finn takes that one away. She's got a breakout going if she can get up the ice. And
she can.
Oh, just lost that one, though. It stopped her momentum, so they had to give it up. Nets with it now. That one gets thrown in. And to no one's surprise, Don, both these teams, just everybody can skate so well.
Oh, my gosh. Oh,
that's going to be a penalty.
Finn's going to pick up a penalty for a trip there.
I understand why that happened, why Finn thought she had to go down. That's a tough one. Otherwise, I mean, I think she was just going to go around her and drive right to Solnitsky.
Yep.
And it's that kind of penalty where it's like, yes, I think as a coach I could be okay with that.
Yeah, and Abby Lindeck, like I said, she's been aggressive, and that was her being aggressive again, getting that puck, heading toward the net. Addie Finn doesn't want any part of that.
That one comes out to the top. Nets loses her footing for a second. Able to get back up and flip it. St. Martin fighting for it. Comes away for St. Martin. She's going to throw that around the boards, and that's going to go all the way out. Pulaski has to come out and hold on to it.
Boy, and at just under 11 minutes left in this period, critical time here for Stillwater to kill the penalty off.
And that one's cleared by Lang. Crowd of the bench happy for that one.
Yeah, amazing that you can clear the zone like that. Usually you have the players pinch on the sides to make sure that doesn't happen.
Yeah, it looked like it just hopped the Woodbury player's stick there. That one thrown in the middle. Again, that's what they like to do. And it's been working so far for them tonight.
Lang doing a good job shutting down Woodbury. Takes two players to take the puck away from her.
Yeah, that was killing off good couple seconds there. Desjarnet out to poke it away. Big fight in front of the net.
Boy, and you can see the difference. Now there are ponies in front of the net.
Solnitsky couldn't grab that at first. Finally does. Yeah, that's maybe what Stillwater was missing in the beginning.
Right.
Having that front net presence to help, you know, their goaltender. But now, I mean, you could see it there. I mean, they were not giving an inch. Cheney in there, Lang in there.
Yeah, Haley Grunke had a goal in the first period, I think, because they gave her space in front. And you can't, definitely can't do that, and Stillwater's adjusted in this period.
Woodbury wheels it around again. They get it back up to the top. That shot comes in. Not sure what happened there to St. Martin.
St. Martin got hit in the face with the stick.
Yeah, and she is down.
I think she got the butt end of it as she came around. between two Woodbury players. She's shaken up. Trainer coming out on the ice.
Yeah, I mean, she's grasping at her throat.
Yeah, I think she got hit by the end of the stick when she was trying to defend two of the players. She's checking her. I think she's checking to see if there was a cut or something, perhaps. We'll see if we got footage of that play here. St. Martin will be on the right side. There she is down on the ice. I saw her going between two Woodbury players. And then, you know, there's been a lot of scrapping and fighting. We've seen the sticks flying around. Mm-hmm. Finn's lost her stick a couple times. I think Finn loses her stick because she decides that the stick's not worth getting hit. And
right.
In that case, I think St. Martin took one, and she's off the ice now. We'll see if she's getting tended to.
Yeah, it seems to be incidental contact. Obviously no call. As Woodbury still on the power play, sets it up, has a player in front.
And that
high stick
is a high stick by Natalie Meter. Now, to be fair, she swings afterwards. She's laughing. She did slap that puck straight down. She was trying to slap it down to herself, I think. But it was so high and the angle was wrong that it ends up bouncing off. Let's see if we can catch that look here. They're going to have a face-off in the other zone right here. She just slaps it down. She knew immediately that wasn't going to be a goal. I think, just St. Martin is back out on the ice. She's here to take the face-off.
Yeah, I mean, that slap was almost, it was too good.
She knew.
Yeah. So no goal. 8 more seconds till Finn is out. Janie goes cross ice. Misses everybody.
That's going to end this power play. Woodbury, 1-for-3.
A couple good chances for the Royals. St. Martin. Pressures, gets it down on Pulaski. It comes out.
Last time that happened, it went in the net. And we were trying to figure out who did it.
Woodbury carries it in, drops it back, no one's there.
Nice drop.
Finn with it now. Fresh legs for Finn, she drops it back. They go cross ice. Nelson with the shot. That gets deflected.
I'm so surprised Finn didn't shoot it earlier when she was coming down. She does that a lot. She's got a good slap shot.
Yeah, but just as good of a passer, though, too.
Oh, absolutely. But I think if you give her space, she's often going to shoot
right.
It. Same Nelson. Kind of thing St. Martin does.
Driving it in, and Nelson with the goal. 6-5, Stillwater. It didn't look like she had a ton of space on that near side. But
no, she chipped it up, went from low to high, and was able to beat the Woodbury goaltender over the corner. Let's take a look at it. Here
yeah,
she comes.
Yeah, just took it from her.
Oh, I'm sorry. I thought she went high. She went around her.
Looked like it maybe hit off of the underarm, maybe?
I thought she had chipped it up, but yeah, wow, what a great goal by Brooke Nelson. And unbelievably, we are now 6-5 Stillwater.
Again, Don, I would not have predicted this based on the first period, but here we are, and that's why hockey's incredible. I think that was Brooke Nelson all by herself unassisted.
And Stillwater has 2 goals in this period. Woodbury has not been able to score for quite some time. Chard got chopped at, and now her stick's on the ice.
Solonitsky, ooh, another whack there. Finn says something to number 22.
And she's not done talking, by the way. If you can read lips, I would recommend you turn away.
It was a little bit of a late hit, but again, that's hockey. As
it is, and if the puck's loose, it's hard to blame a player for wanting to go after it.
Absolutely. 7.5 left here, Don. I got to imagine the intensity can only go up.
I think Josie St. Martin got another assist on that last goal by Brooke Nelson.
Oh, Desjarnet made a great play. Desjarnet with it again, hacking at it. Wow, Desjarnet had a great sequence there.
I tell you, there are a lot of times when I'm watching the game, I watch Dee Darnette, and I just think she's so close. Like, to yes. so, she's right there. You can just see it. I mean, as a fan, I'm watching the game saying, wow, she is right there. She's just got to do one more thing, and she's going to have lots of points and lots of success. She has had some good success this season, but I just see so much more. She's so close on so many opportunities, so many plays.
Yeah, I mean, and she, right off the face-off here, right in front of us, she did such a great job to just poke that away, and she was off to the races along with her line mate Olivia Williams, set her up for a first shot and then got it back and almost banged one home as St. Martin takes the face-off here. Nelson skating around. Goes back around. St. Martin trying to pick it up with Laska. Woodbury player goes down for it. Lang spins around, tries to keep it in. Woodbury coming away with this one. Still not out yet, though. Now it's out. Fanned on it, though.
Nelson gets it. About to put it back in.
Oh, good move off. Good pass to herself there. Drags it in. 2-on-1. Oh, goes wide. Oh, my goodness. It was 2-on-1. I think that was Nets. It was either Nets or Bricko, but she had it to herself.
Lanny Nets was just coming through and just deking and showing off all her skills, and it was not rewarded with a goal, but she sure put in a goal-worthy effort there. Stillwater fortunate that Zelensky was able to stay in the way.
It was 2-on-0, and, you know, I normally am okay with taking shots like that, but that might have been the one time where you wanted to pass it off. She had a player right on the back door, but she took the shot, went wide. Regardless, though, what an incredible move by Nets. Passed to herself off the sideboard. Finn takes that, goes cross ice, launches it for Hackler.
Oh, nice. Nice chip forward. And you're seeing the players try to work together now. It's something we haven't seen.
Yeah, it's
certainly in the last game, you didn't see a lot of tic-tac tandem action. Now we're seeing people working together.
It's not just shooting for yourself.
Right.
Hackler taking it. She'll dump it in. Rose fighting for it. Woodbury comes away with it, though. Marge having to play defense. Marge trying not to get beat up the sideline.
Does a good job tying her up.
Hackler with it. Dumps it in as she goes off for a change.
Well, I tell you, now we're looking at just over 5 minutes left in this period. Someone's going to win this game.
Finn lost her footing. Solnitsky right there. Good shot, though.
Finn comes back to pick up the rebound, gets it out of there.
Oh, good stick there by Williams. They had two players in the middle. Williams did a good job to break that pass up. That one gets tipped in behind the net. Woodbury rings it around the boards. Try to go cross ice. Hit the Stillwater stick. That one gets thrown in. Solnitsky drops it for Lang.
Way wide of the net, but she collects it anyway, not taking any chances. And I think Lang puts her hands on her helmet as she's going to ice that puck. It's coming right back.
Just missed Desjardins. 4.5 left here, Don. Stillwater up 6-5. Shots 24-28 in favor of Woodbury.
Yeah, Woodbury trying to tie this up after, you know, after that first period. It sure looked like they had a good stranglehold on this game. Ponies fought back, assisted by power plays.
Nelson chips that behind the net. Woodbury coming away with it. Lang goes down, tried to toe drag it.
Boy, and Josie St. Martin did a great job sticking her stick in there, preventing the Woodbury player from getting any chance to shoot it. think it was number 22, trying to bring it down
that's
the ice.
Boone.
Madison Boone, yep. She was trying to get in, find space, and do a shot, and St. Martin took her stick and got it in the way.
Well, Lang, too, was there, and then she fell down, which gave Boone the opening, and so
yes.
St. Martin had to come back at the last second.
And you know what? I think that's something we had kind of talked about, right? Don't let your goalies, stop your goalies from facing shots.
Woodbury wheeling it around now. Tried to throw it to the middle. A lot of bodies there. Never went through.
No, I say for a split second, no one was covering Natalie Meter.
Finn collects this one. Goes cross ice. Oh,
Robinson tried to deke around.
Almost had a
the
good
captain
move there.
For Woodbury, and I guess you wear that C for a reason. You're not getting past me.
Woodbury now trying to find some space. That goes right into a Stillwater skate, though. Stillwater needed a change.
So that worked out to their advantage.
Stillwater changing quite frequently here in the last couple minutes. Nelson drives in. Pulaski has to hold on to that one.
3:04 left in this period.
Well, Don, if you're Stillwater, do you try not to play too aggressive? Because we know what happens when teams play not to lose.
No, I think you play like it's tied. You do what Brooke Nelson is doing there. She brings it down the ice, and she does what she's here to do, score goals.
That's right. Here comes Woodbury, though, up the side. That one gets thrown in. Lang collects it. Goes up the side for Nelson. Nelson chips it up. St. Martin right there to collect it, just like clockwork. Drives in, takes a shot. There's a rebound potentially. Laska hitting it away at it.
Again, the puck is loose, so you can't be mad for players for going for it.
No, of course not. And honestly, I didn't even really think that Nelson chipped it the way she wanted to off the boards there. But it doesn't matter. I mean, it still caught St. Martin in full stride, and she drove to the net. Laska was right there.
Yeah, and I think Lasica was trying to find it herself because it was kind of loose flying around.
St. Martin.
Oh, Lasica almost had a chance at that, but Lang does.
Yeah, Lang takes the shot. Backhand. Oh, Nelson was right there on the back door. Just skipped by her, though.
Great setup by her teammate.
Oh, man, good job by Lang there because she had two Woodbury Royals right there as Nelson brings it in. She's going to take it herself. Loses it, though. Got some speed now coming up the side. Takes a shot, and that gets floated in off of a Lang stick.
Lang lost her stick, but found the puck.
Yeah, that was a shot by Meter. She had Lang by, like, maybe a half step.
Yeah. Meter's the one who had that high stick opportunity, number 13. She's been very dangerous tonight.
Don, we got to keep an eye on what Coach Scott Waldo wants to do as far as pulling the goalie at some point here for Woodbury.
Yeah, 2:09 left in this period.
Stillwater wins that faceoff, but they're not the first one there as it goes around. That one fires in, and that just tips off of a player. Wow. There were two players there. Finn was there, and that took an odd carom off of a stick, but that's what happens.
I think I saw Abby Ledick with the redirect as the puck was being shot in. Keep an eye on number 16 on your left.
Yeah, it all kind of started with her there too as she got to the puck first.
She certainly is the one that got jumped into by her teammates.
Tie game here, 2:01 left, and that's gonna be a timeout. Yeah, that's Lenzik with the goal.
Yep, she redirected the puck that was shot in. Really good work as a tandem there, where you had one player shoot it and another one redirect it. That's what you have to do when you're trying to beat a great goaltender like Stillwater's goaltender.
And really, it started on this faceoff where Stillwater won the faceoff, but nobody went to collect the free puck. And then Woodbury just did a good job of cycling up to the top, and Lenzik was right there.
I'm not sure I had a I was kind of expecting a 6-6 goal game the other night. Didn't get one. Get it tonight.
Yeah, they're making up for lost time, I guess.
This is a this is going to be a battle to the end, and then maybe some, and then some.
This could be a very long 2:01 left here in this game, Don.
Right, smart timeout, I think. Settle down the team. I like that move. And if I look at MN Girls Hockey, they list Abby Lindsay even strength when assist by Fashing, number 23. So 20 Page is the one who took the shot, and
Lenzik with the goal.
Lenzik redirected it.
Another shot deflected by Solnitsky.
Well, and you can see Finn and...
Finn catches that one.
Finn
good
and Boone were tangling.
That one played back into the neutral zone. Lang has to play it.
Whoa.
Oh, St. Martin gets clipped there. Oh, she fans on it. Wide open in the front. Oh, goes wide. Smart move to go right, shoot left.
Finn laid out for it on the defensive side to prevent any type of attack.
Nelson trying to play it up the side.
Woodbury is not done.
No, they've resurged here in the last couple of minutes. Lang fires it in. Just approaching a minute left here in this game. Don't go anywhere, ladies and gentlemen. Finn now.
Stillwater looking to be very patient. Oh, a lot of contact there.
Contact
Lenny
both
Nets
ways.
Goes down.
Desjarnet taking it in herself. Trying to get it back to the middle with to St. Martin, but that gets picked off.
Woodbury's doing a great job of shutting down all of the opportunities, all the lanes.
That one gets poked free, though, past Lang. Finn has to come back for help. Sprawls out. Still again, 2-0. Solnitsky makes the save. Oh, my goodness. Finn made a great sprawling save on the first shot.
Haley Gronke paid for going after that puck. I did not see any penalties called here. They're going to have a face-off outside.
Outside the zone.
And, Solnitsky did a great job.
Oh, inside the zone.
Fighting
still.
Off all of the defenders.
I mean, what a great stop by Solnitsky.
She had two Woodbury players in front of her.
Yeah, and Finn made such a great stop there, too, to stop the first pass. It was, again, another fortuitous bounce for Woodbury that started all that.
But Woodbury doing a great job getting down in the middle of the space and creating great opportunities.
That one rifled out by Lang. About 7 seconds left here. Maybe one more rush. And the horn will sound.
So we have three goals in that period. Bell McKenzie assisted by Addie Finn. And then we had Brooke Nelson scored, assisted by St. Martin. And then Abby Letznik assisted by Paige Fashing. So a 4-5 game turned into a 6-5 and then became 6-6.
And I can't imagine both teams just want to say, let's just end this one in a tie tonight, huh, Don?
I don't think it's going to work out that way. We got, shots on goal are pretty good. We got 27-31 is what I'm looking at. And we have a good game for both teams. Woodbury took advantage of every opportunity they got, made some great goals to take a 4-0 lead. They have to be pretty happy about that. They have to be very frustrated by Stillwater coming back and then them being down. But they also have to be very happy about coming back and scoring with like 2 minutes left in this game to force an overtime.
Yeah, it seemed like they were asleep for that for the most of the third period until that last like 5 minutes. The Woodbury offense really surged again, and
defensively
very
too.
Yeah,
I think defensively they started to clog up and stop the opportunity. You didn't really see Stillwater being able to work anything out for a little bit there at the end of the game.
And Stillwater did a great job. They kept their foot on the gas. They still were trying to make plays. I don't think they got too safe,
nope.
You know, quote unquote. But it was just a. You know, again, a tough shot for Solnitsky, and honestly, like I said, I think both goalies have done a tremendous job, especially Solnitsky having to come in relief tonight. And she has not faced easy shots.
No, and she's faced the best. I think she's faced some really quality, like that opportunity at the end there to have, that's got to be a nightmare as a goalie. You wake up and there's two blue jerseys right in front of you and a puck sitting there, and you're just going to have to stop them. She did a great job of preventing this game from not going to overtime, because that would have been a 7-6 win for Woodbury.
Well, folks, we still have some extra hockey here, so it'd still be a great time to call Papa John to Stillwater to get that pizza for this. I don't know if it'll get there before overtime's done, but
well, you can. Maybe it's a celebratory dinner, depending on which city you're
right.
in.
Both teams now huddling up.
Lots to talk about. You see Finn giving Solnitsky a big hug before the game, and St. Martin's out on the ice. Brooke Nelson, Josie Lang, and Bryn Laska.
And remember, Solnitsky is just a ninth grader, Don.
Right. I don't even want to say just. I think I want to take the just out there. She is a ninth grader and facing the, you know, best players in the country, basically, when you're looking at this. Any team that's on the ice, you're seeing the best players in the country, just
Minnesota.
And there's
always a question of when your goalie's a senior in Lily Timmons, what are you going to do after, you know, those seniors leave? But, I mean, if Solnitsky plays like this against some of the top competition in the state, I mean, they're in good hands. That one gets blocked, though.
Blocked up high.
Woodbury throwing it around early.
Really smart placement, too, of that puck, trying to see if they can beat her on the stick side.
That one gets thrown in by Woodbury. Finn has to play it. Lang looking for a breakout. Nothing there, so she might have to go up the sideline. Tipped in by St. Martin.
Key is to make
sure Laska.
Avoid any bad turnovers.
Laska gets taken down.
She looked back, but I don't think they're going to call that in overtime.
No. They're going to let him play.
Oddly enough, some penalties are different.
Right.
Based on the clock.
Solnitsky stops that shot from Nets.
Yeah, they're just trying to see if they can sneak one by.
Nets having to be tested early on here in this overtime. That one will ring around the boards. Nelson tries to touch it out. It does exit the zone. Thrown right back in. Finn with it. Considered going cross ice to Laska there for a second. Finds Lang instead. Nelson up the side. Tried to chip it. Didn't get enough on it. Takes it back, though.
Laska got a piece of it.
Nelson stick handling it. Takes a shot. Too many blue jerseys. Still has it somehow. Drops it off for St. Martin. St. Martin picks her head up, tries to go around, throws it out to the front. Nelson with it, has a player in the front. Dumps it around. That was Finn on the other side. Desjarnette, sorry. Backhand by Desjarnette.
Some back and forth action there with St. Martin and Desjarnette. They're still on the attack with Lang firing, ripping one.
That one stays. That one finally goes out. Crazy rush there for Stillwater, though. Desjarnette had a great backhand. St. Martin brings it in, though. Takes a shot. Block or save by Pulaski. That one's going to go all the way down, though. Woodbury just wanted to stop the bleeding.
Yeah, and Pulaski did a great job. Well, once she chipped that up, she got back in the net and like made herself as big as possible, making sure that nothing snuck through there. That's Woodbury's. Iced it, gets a breather, and now they're going to have to face the attack again.
Stillwater dumps that one in. Woodbury trying to rifle it around the boards. Can't break away from Rose, though. Williams in on it as well.
Chaney does a good job defending the player. Now Rose gets it.
Tried to just throw it on net, but fanned on it. Good positioning there by March, though, to get in front. Otherwise, there's a player going. Couple whistles. Couple players go down. There's a stick on the ice.
Sure looks like it's a Woodbury penalty based on the reaction.
Yep.
Number 12, Bella Miskashov. Number 18's going into the net. Into the sin bin. Not net. Sorry.
That's Nets going off. That's maybe their top player. I guess offensively, yes, that is their top player.
She is their leading point scorer with 27 goals on the season.
We're going to get, it looks like, another timeout.
Probably by Woodbury.
Well done.
2 minutes for interference.
That's on Lady Nets. Well done. If there's going to be any time to do it, I would imagine this next 2 minutes is the time to do it if you're Coach Cashman's team.
Yeah. I mean, they have been, they've done well on the power play tonight. And the Jeopardy music is played for us.
Lots of fans in the stands right now to see the end of this game. A thrilling game.
Yeah, really pretty amazing back and forth that's been going on today. Really looked like, I'm sure there are some people that tuned out after that first period when it was 4-1. But if they, hopefully they got word that things have changed.
No, Don, I for sure thought it was going to be a 6-6 overtime game after that.
Yeah, I didn't. So I was really confused about what was happening.
Team set here to come back onto the ice. I feel like a broken record, Don, whenever I say this power play is the most important of the season. This power play is super crucial.
Right.
But this power play right now is maybe the most important one of the season so far. Addie Finn takes it, gets it back. Lang wanted it. St. Martin going to create some space for her. Lang, see if they actually give her some space over here. They don't. Probably a smart move. Goes down to St. Martin. Tried to go up in the middle to Nelson, but good defense there. Chaney has it. Gets it to Lang. Stillwater working it down. That one gets chipped away. Woodbury.
Brooke Nets.
Yeah, takes it. Takes a shot. Deflects off to the side. Lang collects it. Woodbury changes a couple players. Stillwater trying to break out. Get right back in on the attack.
Boy, that, you know, whatever they're doing, they figured out a good way to keep Josie St. Martin off for her skating legs. She's been down on the ice a good number of times tonight. They figured something out with her.
Yeah, not give her any space so far. I mean, she's so deadly when she's got space to work, and she's so deadly when there's no space to work. So I guess the best option maybe to get her off her skates, like you said, is Lang holds on to this one. Just missing Finn. Collects it. We'll go back up to Lang. Lang has to turn around, but gets immediately pressured. This one exits the zone, though, for Chaney.
Yeah, good defense by Madison Boone.
Stillwater can't really set up and get in there, get in the zone like they normally can. St. Martin just going to take this one. Ooh, didn't catch it cleanly, Pulaski, but then jumps on it. So this is the opportunity to set up their offense with about 32 seconds left here in the power play. Woodbury has done a great job of killing it off so far. You saw in that replay there that Pulaski had it on her. It went off the bottom of her glove.
Finn wins the faceoff.
St. Martin takes a shot. Not much on it.
Finn was camped out in front. Shot was right into the goalie.
Woodbury trying to break out. Doing a great job there was Lang giving support. St. Martin now could be numbers. Oh, good stick there, though. Shot coming in again. Action not over yet. Nelson fighting with it, ultimately losing it. Chaney comes up. And there's full strength. Nets out the box. Lang has to play it, and that'll be icing.
Yeah, and Brooke Nets has done a good job tying up the players defensively for Woodbury, number five. She's done a great job preventing any continuity there. And with 3:29 left, we are at even strength, even goals, and shots are 30-33.
Yeah. Brooke Nets has been incredibly valuable for the Woodbury side. Stillwater trying to come away with this one, and they do. McKenzie with it, spins around, has it, kicks it up to herself. Pulaski jumps on that one, though. Desjarnette was circling. She was right there.
Yeah, McKenzie's a sophomore, so you start saying, you know, someone in the next level might come through and win this game. They certainly have needed contributions by everyone tonight.
Finn with it, throws it at net. Ooh, and that one glides just wide. McKenzie trying to keep it in, furiously trying to keep it in. That one goes out. Woodbury has it now. Coming up, that's going to miss everybody. Lang has it. Loses it for a minute, will collect it herself. Go up the sideline there for Finn. Finn goes cross ice. That one on net. Pulaski will hold on to it. Stillwater will just reset again.
2:49 left in the period. And so far what we haven't seen in this period is some kind of turnover that leads to an opportunity. The key is to not create one of those for either team.
And you can see Woodbury really wanting to try to capitalize on a fast break or a long stretch pass. Just haven't connected yet. Stillwater doing a good job of trying to keep the puck in.
Some consultation here by the referees before we drop the puck.
St. Martin loses that one. Woodbury brings it up. Nets with speed coming in. A lot of hockey's been played, but Nets still has a lot of gas in the tank. She's still skating hard. Turnaround shot, that goes wide. Throw that one out to the front, but no Woodbury players are there. Stillwater trying to break out. Can't seem to get it out of their own zone, though. And that's going to be a penalty.
I think St. Martin's going to pick up the tripping on Lanny Nets with 2:19 left in the period in this overtime. St. Martin in the box.
That's tough for Coach Cashman's team. One of your best penalty killers and best players going into the box in a crucial spot here, but we saw this on Tuesday where numerous players went off and they were able to kill this. Quick shot there goes wide. Woodbury cycles this up. Nets thought about bringing it in, turns around. She'll shoot it in. Deflection there. Solnitsky, though.
Scoops it out of the air. It popped up, and she said, I'm not going to let it hit the ice.
Yep, snatched that one.
.205 in the period. Extra period.
Finn takes the faceoff. Lang tries to get it out. Oh, good job keeping it in. That one misses her, though.
Just out of range of Haley Gronke, luckily for Stillwater.
Oh, just out of the range of Nelson, too, who was on her horse for that. Nelson takes it herself, though. Oh, had no help. Obviously, they're on a penalty kill.
Finn going to throw that in. It goes off of Brooke Netz's chest.
And that's going to be another penalty on Desjarnet. She ended up tripping the Woodbury player. Penalties coming at the wrong time for Stillwater. A minute 29 left here in this game. 6-6 on VAC TV. Nelson doing such a great job by herself. And then Desjarnet came up to try to make a play and just ended up getting in the way and tripping that player. Yeah, just caught her on the very end there. That was Nets that went down.
Yeah, and Solnitsky, who subbed in for Lily Timmons in the first period, is really, really being tested.
You know, Don, I really think regardless of the outcome of this game, Solnitsky did her job tonight, which Coach Cashman will be happy for in that regard.
Absolutely true. I agree with you there. Woodbury taking a moment here to talk. 5-on-3, 1:11 left in the St. Martin penalty, the first one.
So I'm
a full 2 minutes on the second.
We have Finn, Nelson, and Lang, I would imagine, as the killers here for Stillwater. Nelson going for it. That one exits the zone. Woodbury gonna quickly try to rotate around as they try to re-enter the zone. She drives, takes a shot. But Solnitsky gloves it.
We'll have a faceoff here. 1:11 left.
That was Mishikov.
At some point, you mentioned a tie earlier. It sure is looking like that's a best-case scenario for Stillwater at this moment. Down two players for the rest of this period. Pretty much.
Right. Yeah, they'll get St. Martin back, potentially with just a little bit left in the game.
Yeah, 20 seconds, less than 20 seconds.
That one gets tied up in the middle. Woodbury works back up, takes the shot. Oh, kick save there. He's going for a pass. I don't know if it ever got to the second Woodbury player. Nelson's going to shoot that out. Doesn't work it out, though. Another one coming in. And that one gets flipped out. And here comes Pulaski. She's got to make a move on it. And Finn lost her stick. And that's going to be a penalty on Nets, I think. Finn was off to the races and got her stick knocked out of her hand, I think.
Atlanta Nets gets another, Lanny Letts gets another penalty late in this game. 42 seconds left.
And if you weren't sure what was going to happen, Don, in this game, you can be even more unsure.
Yes.
What's going to happen in these next 42 seconds here.
Yeah, and in 24 of them, we'll see St. Martin come out of the box. Shots on goal are 31-36. Numbers slowly crept up.
So we'll have a 4-on-3 power play here for Woodbury. Lots of open ice, and these teams skate so well. Woodbury dancing their way into the zone. Lang and Finn fend that attack off.
Oh, does a good job. Lang does a good job poking that loose.
Lang almost had that. Nelson with it. Comes up the board. I really do think Nelson is out of gas. St. Martin coming back on. Takes a shot. That one rings high.
10 seconds left.
I think Nelson is absolutely gassed right now. Finn holds on to it.
Smart Finn, play.
Yeah, she might have had a pass, but you don't want to go for it. And that one's going to end it, ladies and gentlemen. What a game. You know, for a second there, I thought Finn maybe had Nelson up the middle. There was traffic, but she might have had her. But
she didn't want to risk a turnover.
I don't blame her for that one bit.
Boy, and this was quite the battle. I mean, game started off 4-1 after the first period. With the amazing part of that first goal by Stillwater scored with 1 minute left in that first period.
Yeah.
And then Stillwater does a great job of taking advantage of the power play and getting into this game. Took the lead, amazingly enough, but Woodbury was not going to go away. They were not going to let their initial rush go for naught, and we end up in a 6-6 game with lots of numbers up on the board. You have still two players still in the box when this game ended. We have plenty of penalties. And, man, shots on goal, 31-36. But the 12 goals scored, none of them easy. None of them cheap. None of them fluky. Just a solid, solid amount of hockey being played out there.
And really, like I said, I mean, I think we've praised her all game. I think, honestly, the player of the game for me is, you know, Haley Solnitsky coming in relief of Lily Timmons. I mean, it's such a tough position to play on top of being able to just say, hey, you're in now.
Right.
And, I mean, she was up to the task, and she did everything she could to keep Stillwater in this game, where at the time she came in, it was 4-0.
Right. And the goals that were given up were nothing slacker. You know, there were two that were over the shoulder.
Right, yeah,
And when Timmons said, after the fourth goal, I saw Timmons shrug. She's like, what am I supposed to do? Like, these guys are scoring great goals on me. I don't know what to say. So, happy hi to all the kids. Yep, good. Good to see you, kids. Thanks for stopping by.
But, yeah, I guess I would say a good overtime game. I mean, for Stillwater, obviously there was a lot they, you know, might have desired. But really, I mean, to pull within even, to have the lead, to go down to three players, you know, in the overtime.
And hang on. It was 5-on-3 in overtime.
Yeah.
And they fought through that and were able to get out
right.
without a loss. I think that's a huge credit.
Because, again, you come into this game and you go overtime 5-on-3 and then you lose in that way. I mean, that's a heartbreaker.
But that's
to fight through like they did, that shows grit and determination. And like I said, I think there's a lot that Coach Cashman and this team can be very proud of tonight as they battled back to make this a 6-6 tie here at the Rec Center.
Amazing game, really powerful matchup. And, man, I'm interested to see what happens next.
Well, with that, we're going to sign off. Thanks for tuning in tonight on VAC TV. I want to thank Don, my partner here. Thank Anders Engstrom and the crew. Thanks for tuning in on Valley Access Channels as the Ponies tie Woodbury 6-6. And we'll see you in the next one.
Trying to make dinner again.
Got the ketchup and mustard?
Yep.
Got the relish?
Yep.
Hot dogs and buns?
Yep. Got the charcoal?
Uh-oh. We're out of charcoal.
What? What are we gonna eat?
Don't worry, I got you covered.
Hello.
Wow, that was quick.
Yep, thank you very much.
Thank you, have a good night.
You too.
Hey guys, Papa John's.
Thanks. Oh, yummy.
How'd you know?